Good morning, class. Welcome to the e-classes of St. Joseph's Academy. I, Shivani Sharma, your English teacher. Today, I will teach you English second, that is Mulberry. Poem second, Lullaby by Ellen Norman Bowles. Now class, we will start the poem. Now, first you tell me, what do you mean by lullaby? Lullaby means a song which helps in sleeping of children. A lullaby is a song that is gentle and restful. It is usually sung to help children sleep. The words of a lullaby are usually simple and repetitive. Lullabies have existed since ancient times and are sung all over the world in different languages. Now, we will start reading the poem. Close your eyes gently and cuddle in. Keep yourself snug. A new day will begin. Have pleasant dreams about those things you love. Sleep is an island waiting above. These lines mean, close your eyes gently and cuddle in. Keep yourself snug, a new day will begin. It means, just close your eyes very calmly and hold something closely in your arms. After holding something, keep yourself warm. And after that, a new day will begin. Means you got dreams after sleeping, and in dreams you feel like a new day will begin. Have pleasant dream about those things you love. Sleep is an island waiting above. Now, have some nice and enjoyable dreams about the things you love, and sleep is like an island which is waiting for you. There, in your dreams, just dream something which is very nice and enjoyable and that you love very much, and you feel like sleep is an island in which You are waiting for someone. Night is a blanket keeping you warm. If you close your eyes, you can come to no harm. Dreams are like journeys drifting along. Rest is a present keeping you strong. Now, do you like me? Night is a blanket keeping you warm. If you close your eyes, you can come to no harm. Means, night is like a blanket for keeping you warm. And if you will close your eyes, you do not get any harm, means you can sleep peacefully at night. Dreams are like journeys drifting along. Rest is a present keeping you strong. It means your dreams are like a journey which are moving slowly, and the other things are your present that will keep you strong. This poem is written by Ellen Norman Bowl. So class, just write the poem in your copy and learn it. Now, these are the hard words. But before writing the hard words, class, just write page number 2 on a new page. Just write poem number 2 little by, and then write the poem. And after writing the poem, on the next page, write the hard word. So I am reading the hard word. First one is cuddle. 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 Next is pleasant. 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 Next, drifting. 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 Last one is snug. 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 Write the hard words very neatly and cleanly in your copy. Now, after the hard words, we will write the word meaning. First one is snug. It means warm and safe. Snug, warm and safe. Next, pleasant. Pleasant means nice. Pleasant means nice. Third one is drifting. Drifting means moving slowly. Drifting means moving slowly. Snug means warm and safe. Pleasing means nice. Drifting means moving slowly. Now, this is the exercise. Like question number 1, the poem is a lullaby. Which of these words would we include in a morning song? Underline them. Poem is a lullaby, which is mainly sung in the night. this is a question in which we have to write the word or we have to underline the word that we can include in our morning song or morning prayer. The words are close, gently, cuddle, snug, pleasant, dream, sleep, blanket, warm, journey, rest, song. So these are the words that are given, but you have to underline the words which we can use in our morning song. First one is gently. So underline the word gently. Next, pleasant. Underline it, pleasant. Next, warm. Underline warm. Next, journey. Underline journey. Now class, write the question answer. Question number 2. Read these lines and answer the questions that follow. You have to read the lines and write the answers. You can find the answers from these lines. Close your eyes gently and cuddle in. Keep yourself snug. A new day will begin. Have pleasant dreams about those things you love. Sleep is an island waiting above. Question number 1. The first stanza describes three things that we usually do when we go to bed. What are they? I'm repeating the question. The first stanza describes three things that we usually do when we go to bed. What are they? Answer is closing eyes, cuddle in, and keeping oneself snug. I'm repeating the answer. Closing eyes, cuddle in, and keeping oneself snug. Now, second question. What does sleep compare to? Why do you think the poet uses this comparison? I am repeating the question. What is sleep compared to? Why do you think the poet uses this comparison? Answer is, sleep is compared to an island. The poet uses this comparison because there we get peace. I am repeating the answer. Sleep is compared to an island. The poet uses this comparison because there we get peace. Next question. What are the things you like to dream about? I am repeating the question. What are the things you like to dream about? Answer is, we would like to dream about pleasant things. We would like to dream about pleasant things. Now question number 3. Why does the poet say dreams are like journeys? I am repeating the question. Why does the poet say dreams are like journeys? Answer is, the poet says that dreams are like journeys because in dreams we can travel many leagues and we can see many things much like a journey. I am repeating the answer. The poet says that dreams are like journeys because in dreams we can travel many leagues and we can see many new things, much like a journey. Now, question number 4. What does sleep give us with? I am repeating the question. What does sleep gift us with? Answer is, sleep gives us rest. I am repeating the answer. Sleep gives us rest. Now question number 5. Do you like this lullaby? Give reason for your answer. I am repeating the question. Do you like this lullaby? Give reason for your answer. Answer is, yes, we like this lullaby because it takes us to the new world of calmness and peace. I am repeating the answer. Yes, we like this lullaby because it takes us to the new world of calmness and peace. Now, similes and metaphors. We will read now about similes and metaphors. Similes and metaphors are comparable. These are the words or these are the things, similes and metaphors, we mostly use in the poem. And these are like the comparisons. In poems, we always do the comparison of things with the people or real life. So it means similes and metaphors are comparisons. A simile says one thing is like another. Simile means one thing is like another. Similes use the word like or as. In simile, we use like or as. For example, dreams are like journeys. Now, here we compare dreams to the journeys. And on the next example, she is as wise as an owl. And we compare a girl with an owl as she is very wise as an owl. Got it? Now it's about metaphor. A metaphor says one thing is another. In metaphor, we say that one thing is another. For example, sleep is an island. Now we are saying sleep is an island. So we are saying one thing is another. Now, night is a blanket. Night is a blanket. Here, and she is a wise owl. We have compared a girl with a owl. It's like she is a warehouse. Now I'm repeating. Similes and metaphors are comparisons. A simile says one thing is like another. Similes use the word like or as. For example, dreams are like journeys. She is as wise as an owl. A metaphor says one thing is another. For example, she is an island. Night is a blanket. She is a wise owl. Now, we will do some exercise related to similes and metaphors. Okay, class? Now, question number one. Write am against the sentences with metaphor and s against the sentences with simile. You have to write am for those sentences that are of metaphor and s for those sentences that are of simile. Okay. So, first one is books are treasure chest. Books are compared to treasure chest. We compared one thing to another. So it is the metaphor. M. Write am here. Next one. Reading a book is like taking a journey into new land. Here, in the sentence, we used word like and we used the word like or as in the similes. So, this sentence is of simile. So, write S here. Next one. My pillow is as soft as a cloud. Same thing, we have used S in the sentence. So, it's also of simile. Write S here. Next one. My grandmother is a mountain of strength. Now, we have compared here grandmother to the mountain of strength. So, it is a metaphor. Write M here. Next one. Our teacher is a walking encyclopedia. Here also we compared our teacher to the encyclopedia. Here also we write M. It's also a metaphor. Next, he is an angel. Here also we compare one thing to another. That is, he an angel. So write M for metaphor here. Next one. The sun is like a pot of melting butter. Here we use the word like. So it's of simile. Write S here. Next one. Next and the last. The man is as old as the hill. Here also we use the word as. So it's also of simile. That is S. Write S here. In first one, we used metaphor M. Second one, simile S. Third one, simile S. Fourth one, metaphor M. Fifth one, metaphor M. Sixth one, metaphor M. Seventh one, S. Eighth one, S. Got it, class? Write this exercise like that in your copy that I have written here. Now question number two. Use metaphors or similes of your own to describe the following. Now you have to make a sentence according to the clues given here. And you can use Whatever you want to use can be your metaphor. So the first one is someone who is clever. Here I have written Ritu is as clever as Fox. Next, someone who is happy. Here I have written Raj is looking as happy as Flood. Next, your best friend. Here I have written, my best friend is as bushy as bee. Next one, your school. My school is a temple of learning. Last one, a butterfly. A butterfly is like a rainbow. Now I am repeating. First one, someone who is clever. Ritu is as clever as Fox. Next, someone who is happy. Raj is looking as happy as Flood. Your best friend. My best friend is as busy as bee. Your school. My school is a temple of learning. A butterfly. A butterfly is like a rainbow. Now it's homework time. Read, write, and learn the poem carefully. Next, write all the work in your English second copies neatly after chapter 3, that is Henry. Next, learn all the exercises. Class, first read the poem, then write the poem in your copy, and then after writing, then learn the poem with the spelling of it. And you have to write this poem in your English second copy along with all the exercises that I have given, and write the poem after chapter 3, that is Henry, and learn all the exercises. Thank you, class. Hope you understood the poem. So try to learn it with exercises. Thank you once again. Bye bye.